today is a very special day for me and all the Indian and for our India, because it is our 73rd Republic Day and it's very exciting. So you all might have known Independence Day, we have celebrated it, and we got our Independence Day on August 15th, 1947. So by that time we didn't have our own rules, our own laws, our own regulations. By that, like, we were following the British laws made by the British government. And then we decided, like, we need our own laws. We need our own rules because this is a separate country. So then we formed a committee where the chairman was Dr. Ambedkar. And they were working 3 years to form all these laws, rules and regulations, and that's called a constitution. So this constitution has 5 main things. People have the freedom to speak. People have the freedom to follow any religion or culture you want. People have the freedom to follow any educational value. People are always treated equally because India is India and all citizens are equal to everyone. And the last one is we have rights to protest against any exploitation, and that's the 5 constitutions. So the tricolor flag was made up of 3 colors and Ashoka Chakra in the middle, which symbolizes the King Ashoka and the national emblem. So what do the 3 colors mean? The first color, which is saffron, means courage. The second color, white, means the purity of the people's minds. And third, the green color. The green color means the fertility of the land and our rich cultural heritage. Okay, so now that we're done with the flags, let's get on to the actual celebration. Okay, so one more thing before we start the celebrations and how we celebrate. And that the tricolor flag was introduced by a person called Pingali Venkaya, and our first president was Mr. Rajendra Prasad, and our current president now is Mr. Ramnath Kovind, and now let's move on to the celebration. So the day before Republic Day, the president gives an amazing speech to the citizens of India. And then the next morning, the actual celebration begins. So the next morning, the chief guests from some foreign chief guests will also be there. And the prime minister and the president will also be there at the event. The president will hoist the flag with our national anthem, and give 21 gun salutes for the fallen soldiers who sacrificed their life for our India and in the war. And then they'll also distribute gallantry awards to the people, and especially to the military people who all risked their lives and also sacrificed their lives for our India, to protect our India, and also to some citizens too who risked their life to protect our India too. And then we move on to the parade. So we do a parade from Rashtrapati Bhavan, then to Rajpath, New Delhi. And by that, we also visit they also go to the India Gate and give a 2-minute silence for all the fallen soldiers in the war. And that's probably it for the parade. And then they also have a grand feast, and they also have a great feast at 29th January to wind up the whole celebration. And that's all for the celebration part. Mostly for this day, who should we think about? And yeah, we should think about the military people and the soldiers and the freedom fighters who sacrificed their lives to give this democracy and make this all possible. And this is, like, you know, really hard to get freedom, and they sacrificed their lives for us. So we have to be very thankful to them. And that's pretty much for today. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Have a happy Republic Day. And I hope you have a great day. And Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, my Instagram, and hit the notification bell and subscribe. And see you guys later in my next video. Love y'all. Bye.